Welcome back. Well, pretty extraordinary accusations this morning in the Sydney Morning Herald. Organised crime has spiralled out of control. New South Wales is facing a crisis with assassinations from gang warfare and the so-called cocaine superhighway used to import millions of dollars of illegal drugs.
We're joined now by New South Wales Deputy Premier and Minister for Police, Paul Toole, in Sydney. Deputy Premier, thanks for your time this morning. These are some pretty startling claims in Nick McKenzie's article. Have you lost control?
Look, I don't believe we have lost control, and I think when you have a look at the New South Wales police force, we have 18,000 police officers across this state, and what we do is we ramp them up from time to time when there are incidents that are occurring across the state, and that doesn't matter whether it's money laundering, whether it's drug crimes, or whether it's gang crimes. We will continue to put the police in the right place at the right time to stamp out these activities.
Did the New South Wales Premier, Dominic Perrottet, as it attests this morning in Nick's article, ignore calls for reforms from two of your most senior police officers?
Well, we are talking about money laundering, and that report this morning was talking about money laundering, and we all know that money laundering is very complex. It's one of those issues that, is really important to get on top of, but it can actually take many different forms. And we understand that the Crimes Commission right now is undertaking an inquiry. Once that inquiry has been complete, those recommendations will come back to the government, and I have no doubt the Premier and myself as the Police Minister will be ensuring that those recommendations are being followed, but also making sure that if additional resources or more support needs to be provided, that will be given to the police here in the state.
That doesn't answer the question, though. Did the Premier ignore calls from two of his senior ministers? Oh, hang on, he's just lost his earpiece there. Sorry, Paul. You're right, you got us?
Yeah, I got you now.
Yeah, I was just saying that doesn't answer the question, though. Did the Premier ignore calls from his two senior ministers?
Look, no, I think the Premier takes advice all the time, and the Premier is always acting on what is on the best interest of the people of this state. We've got a Premier who will continue to serve and work hard for the people right across New South Wales. And I know that the Premier is waiting for the report that is going to come back from the Crimes Commission, and that will be coming back with recommendations. We speak with the Police Commissioner almost weekly. We also talk about what additional resources and what things need to happen there to ensure that they have enough support. And the Premier is very active to that, and the Premier continues to provide the right support that is needed to our police in the state.
This is pretty embarrassing, to be honest. Look, I know you're a straight talker, but look, this is pretty embarrassing. New South Wales Police Assistant Commissioner, this was a private meeting. Stuart Smith has come out saying some pretty extraordinary things, saying, quote, we're swinging pool noodles and the Crims have got guns. I mean, how do you even respond to that?
Yeah, look, I saw those comments this morning, and I was obviously a bit concerned about those comments that were made. But let me also make this point. You know, having been the police minister now for 4 months, I've actually seen operations that are working right across Sydney right now. We've had Operation Hawk, and that's been in operation since October of last year. And that's actually seen like over 250 arrests, has seen 800 charges. It's actually seen 70 firearms that have been taken off the street.
Minister, I'm sorry to interrupt. You have senior police, and I don't know how these things get out, but they only get leaked when people are really ticked off. So there's senior people here saying that not enough is being done. They're also saying that the nation's financial crime agency, AUSTRAC, has been lackluster. There's a succession of allegations made here that are pretty embarrassing for you.
Well, look, AUSTRAC is a Commonwealth across the country matter as well. But I do want to point out, though, that, Carl, we've also got Raptor. We're talking about Raptor. I only announced this week another 30 police officers going towards Raptor, and that's boosting it up to 145. And that's actually dealing with criminal gang networks across Sydney. And I've made the point, and our police will continue to be out there on the beat. They will walk every street. They will knock on doors. They will kick down doors. They will raid businesses. They will raid homes. They will disrupt and they will harass people to ensure that our communities are safe. And if people don't change their way, I'll make it very simple. You know, they can get used to wearing a set of greens and eating using plastic cutlery, because that's the path that they're heading down right now.
Minister, just quickly too, in regards to this latest shooting, do you know who the shooter is?
But we don't know who the shooter is, but we do know that obviously with the incident that occurred this week, you know, it was horrible, it was horrific, and it's not going to be tolerated. There was also two Audis that were nearby the crime scene that were burnt out. We have actually got hold of a weapon that was inside one of those vehicles, and that is undergoing forensics right now.
Okay, good to talk to you. Thank you. Lot on.
Thanks, Minister.
Cargo ship turned crime scene, a drug drop turned deadly. On April 5, the Areti GR Mahuro vessel began its voyage from a port in Argentina. It was carrying soybean powder and, unknowingly to the crew, cocaine. The ship arrived in Newcastle on Sunday evening, docking at the South Channel of the Hunter River. Hours later, members of a crime syndicate arrived, hoping to recover drugs attached to the hull worth millions. But on Monday morning, a male scuba diver was found dead on the banks of the Hunter River, police declaring the area a crime scene, triggering a multi-agency investigation.
This was a well-drilled professional group.
It didn't take long for a breakthrough. Officers swooping on an aspiring reality TV star trying to flee the country in far north Queensland.
Good morning, viewers. Here we are at the Cairns Marina.
The 62-year-old man who once auditioned for Survivor.
I've got my immunity idol.
Arrested and charged, accused of being a key player in the failed drug importation. The super yacht owner, used to a life of luxury, this morning staring down the prospect of life behind bars.
And former New South Wales senior detective Peter Moroney joins us now. Peter, nice to have you on the show.
Thank you.
I mean, this story is absolutely fascinating. And wanted to get your thoughts too, because these reports today that in the Sydney Morning Herald that organised drugs, crime and gang violence out of control in New South Wales. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, look, you've got to look at what's happening. You know, we've got a number of shootings in the streets in Sydney. We got large shipments of cocaine dropping in at all up and down the coastline of New South Wales. What we're seeing is not new. It's just really history repeating itself in terms of we've had shootings around Tilopia Street. It dies off. Darwages and the Razzics, it'll die off and it'll come back. It's an ongoing problem. And is there one solution for it? Probably not.
Drugs, territory, all kinds of things makes it difficult for police to gain any kind of control.
Yeah, absolutely, Cole. All of the above. When you exercise power to take over a certain type of territory, you'll hold it at that level of violence. And if someone wants that, guess what? They've got to come over the top, more violent, more extreme, and then make more violence on the street to get it back. Mm. And that's unfortunately how it is.
So is there anything police can do about it?
Yeah, don't give up. Yeah. Look, Ali, we can't just stop and go, we're being defeated. Probably for as long as you two have both been journalists, we've been dealing with drugs and organised crime. And we're going to continue to do that. But the ingenuity that you see them evolve with, we've got to evolve with as well.
Can they close that cocaine superhighway? I mean, there's so many vessels coming in, there's so many ways of getting into this island nation.
You're spot on, Kyle. Yeah, we can work it and reduce the risk of it, but they're only going to open up another alternative. Back in the 2000s, the highway was towards the Wollongong area and around those ports, pardon me, and now it's just shifted up to Newcastle because you've got more volume, more vessels and less chance of being detected.
Interesting stuff. Thank you.